Welcome everyone to this super valuable presentation to provide you with expert tips and strategies for the SAT math. In the next about 10 minutes or so, you'll be guided through specifics of what to expect on SAT test day, and you'll also be provided with insider tips to help you boost your SAT math score. My name is Dr. Jennifer Winward, and I'm the founder and CEO of Winward Academy. We are so excited to partner with Maya Learning to provide these resources and tips to millions of our students around the world. Now, all of these insider tips and tricks are based on my 20 years of experience coaching and mentoring high schoolers through the SAT and also through the college app process. Now, these tips are going to be incredibly helpful for you if you're taking the SAT even as soon as this weekend, if you're in the middle of studying now and you're going to be taking it in the next few months, or if you're just starting to think about preparing and you just kind of want to start with an overview of what to expect on the SAT math. So let's go through an agenda. I'm going to start by providing an overview of the timing and length of the SAT math section. Then I'm going to go through the types of questions and how frequently they're tested. Now that second part, how frequently they're tested, that's the most important thing. You have to know how frequently each concept comes up so that you can be smart about your studying. And you can prioritize your studying around maximizing your growth by starting with those high impact lessons that are tested the most frequently. Then I'm going to go through my top two tips for the math section with no calculator, and then my top two tips for the math section in which you do get a calculator. So let's start with a general overview of the SAT math. Okay, so between the non-calculator section and the calculator section, so total math between the two, you will answer 58 questions and you have 80 minutes total. Now, what are the types of questions that you'll see? The majority of them are going to be multiple choice, right, where you have option A, B, C, D, and you're picking which one is the right answer. But what's unique to the SAT math, so again, we don't see this on the ACT math section, but what's unique on the SAT math are those grid-in questions. So it means you actually have to solve a question and then just write in an answer. So instead of bubbling A, B, C, or D, you might solve and get that the answer is 10, and then you actually have to write in that you think the answer is 10. Okay, so next let's check out a pie chart that's gonna break down the SAT math section by how frequently each concept comes up. So we're going to start with what comes up on 46% of math questions, just those concepts that revolve around solving algebraic equations. So what do I mean by that? I mean performing things like f of x, linear systems word problems, right? So kind of like those real life algebra problems. Combining units, so knowing how to properly solve and combine if you have multiple terms with x or multiple constants, how do you put those together to be able to solve for a missing variable? Using algebra strategies to solve challenging questions in which you're solving again for variables, of course, because it's algebra. Multiple linear systems, when you're given two lines and then you're trying to find out where do they intersect. SAT loves asking about that. Quadratic, so understanding quadratic formula, understanding graphs of parabolas, where do they intersect the x-axis, those types of questions. And then also completing the square to be able to solve for quadratics. Now, at 46%, right, nearly half of the SAT math questions come from these concepts, right? We're talking 26 or 27 questions out of the 58 total. That means that if you can master these concepts, we're talking about 200 to 300 points out of the 800 total that are coming just from these concepts. What does that mean for you? That means you need to crush all of these areas, right? You need to be so good and so confident with each of these subjects because you're going to see a lot of them and it really adds up to be worth a lot of your score. Okay, the next most frequently tested concept has to do with geometry and graphing fundamentals. So what do I mean by that? I mean coordinate plane, right? X and Y coordinates. I mean when you have to graph a line or solve a line, slope, looking at your main graph. So things like a graph of absolute value of x or x squared or x cubed or the square root of x, right? Those super common graphs that come up a lot in your math classes. Also looking at distance formula, midpoint formula, right? 18% of the math questions. So we're talking about 10 or 11 questions out of those 58 are coming from this concept, which means together they're going to help you garner between 80 and 90 points. Remember, out of 800, you're getting 80 to 90 points just from geometry and graphing fundamentals. What comes next? Next is all about the fundamentals of arithmetic. Mean, median, and mode, right? SAT loves testing this. By the way, ACT does as well. But definitely on the SAT, we see mean, median, and mode, probability. They love percents, especially percent word problems, ratios. 15% of your questions, so 8 or 9 questions out of the 58 are coming from arithmetic fundamentals. 70 to 80 points, that's what it means for you, out of the 800 total, are going to be coming from questions that ask you about these types of concepts. The next most frequently tested concept, algebra fundamentals. So 8% of your questions come from algebra fundamentals. So what do we mean by that? We mean things like key definitions, like what's a prime number, even, least common multiple, greatest common factor, those types of questions. Also combining fractions, right? Adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing fractions. FOIL, factoring, knowing how to combine exponents when you're adding, subtracting, dividing, multiplying, etc. Combining radicals, looking at absolute value, solving for inequalities, right? Big thing with inequalities, of course, is if you multiply or divide by a negative number, you have to remember to switch that direction of the inequality, right? So knowing that you need to prioritize these lessons so that you can master 8% of the questions. So again, 4 out of 5 questions total out of those 58, that breaks down to 40 to 50 points out of the 800 are going to come from your knowledge of these concepts. All right, the next thing I want to do is show you the math formulas that the SAT gives you at the beginning of the non-calculator section and at the beginning of the calculator section. So the biggest mistake students make is they think, oh yeah, the SAT gives me the formulas, so I don't need to worry about memorizing them or practicing with them. That's a big mistake. Okay, just because they give you the equations, you still need to know how to apply them. So you definitely want to make sure that you're still practicing with these equations. And you should also know, right, don't get too excited, because what the SAT will do is they might give you an equation for, you know, how to solve a 30-60-90 triangle or how to solve a 45-45-90 triangle, but then all of a sudden they give you a question that asks for the area of a super weird shape that's comprised of lots of 30, 60, 90, and 45, 45, 90 triangles, and you have to kind of add them all together to find the area, right? So they might give you a place to start, but you need to understand that just because they help you start the question does not mean that you're not going to need other outside knowledge and confidence to be able to take you through the steps to solve the questions. So number one, make sure that you know that these are the formulas given to you. But again, don't get too confident knowing that these equations are here. You still need to practice ahead of time using these equations and making sure that you're applying them properly. Okay, so now that we've kind of talked about math generally, I want to separate it, right? Because the math is coming to you in a non-calculator section and a calculator section. So remember, when you start the test, it's reading first, a short break, writing and language, then we go straight into the SAT math with no calculator. You will not get a break before you start the SAT math with no calculator. You will go straight into it from the writing and language section. The SAT math with no calculator, you've got 20 questions in 25 minutes. Now let's look at how those 20 questions are divided into the different question types. Out of the 20 total, you're going to have 15 that are multiple choice, and you're going to have 5 that are gridded. Remember, gridded means you don't have answer choices. You have to actually solve the question and produce the answer. Now, you have 25 minutes to do this section. Now, remember when we had the pie chart and I kind of showed you the overall breakdown for math? What I want to make sure I call out for you when we're kind of looking and focusing on this no calculator math section is that some of the question types come up more frequently with no calculator and some come up more frequently with a calculator. The no calculator math, right, the concepts that tend to come up the most are things like distributing, combining like terms, complex numbers. They love making sure that you know that I squared equals negative one. FOIL, multiple linear systems. They love doing similar triangles. And SOHCAHTOA, which of course is from a right triangle. Those are the super, super most frequently tested questions in the SAT math with no calculator. So the next thing I want to do is break down the top two types of questions asked in the non-calculator math section and then show you an example of each one. So the first most frequent question type on the SAT math with no calculator is when they ask you to combine units. So if you look at this question, right, you'll notice, first of all, it's multiple choice, so that's the format that I'm showing you first. Second, you'll notice that you have to distribute that negative sign carefully to all three terms in that second set of parentheses, right? Then you have to figure out how to combine so that you're combining things that are alike, right? You combine the x squared y terms together. You combine the y squared together, and then you combine the xy squared together, right? So understanding how to distribute a negative and combine like terms, critically important in the SAT math with no calculator. The other most common question type in the non-calculator math has to do with solving multiple linear systems. So what do I mean by that? I mean that you are given two lines and then your job is to basically figure out how to solve those lines, which really is just a fancy way of saying where do they intersect, right? So you might be asked, what is the x value where they intersect or what is the y value where they intersect? Notice for this question, it's asking where what the x value is. And also I want to make sure that you notice that this question is an example of a grid in, right? We have no answer choices. We are just supposed to solve this question for x, and then whatever we solve for x, we will write in to the grid in. Okay, after you finish the math with no calculator, you get a 5-minute break. By the way, this applies to whether you have regular time or extended time. So you do reading, short break, writing and language, math, no calculator, back to back. Then you get 5 minutes. During those 5 minutes, you want to reset because when you come back, you're going for almost an hour, 55 minutes, to do 38 questions with a calculator. Now, this section is longer. You want to make sure that you are very smart during that break so that you're recharging, so that when you come back from the break, you're feeling ready to go to just jam and do those 38 math questions with a calculator. Now, what are the question types? Again, just like in the non-calculator section, the calculator math is broken down between multiple choice and grid in. Out of the 38 total questions, 30 of them will be multiple choice and 8 of them will be grid in. Now, just as we talked about in the non-calculator math, right? Some of those concepts are more frequently tested without a calculator. Some of those math concepts are more frequently tested with a calculator. So the types of math concepts that we see that are the most frequent, again, when you have a calculator, questions like f of x, real life algebra problems, solving for lines, so putting things into slope-intercept form, solving for slope, percent word problems, they love percent word problems, they'll also ask you sneaky things like converting units, right? So they give you a whole question in terms of minutes, but then the answers are in terms of hours. Those types of things where you have to really read carefully and then convert properly, those types of questions come up a lot in the calculator math section. Okay, so next thing I wanna do, just like we did for the non-calculator, for the calculator math, I wanna go through what are the top two questions asked in this section. So number one, they love asking about slope and slope-intercept form. So you'll notice in this question, right, to be able to solve this question correctly, you need to understand what is the equation of a line. You need to understand what does it mean? What does the y-intercept mean? And then you also have to understand what is slope, right? What is the rate of change of that line as I look across time? The change in Y over the change in X, right? Making sure that you understand the meaning of the slope-intercept form of a line and then the various components, right? What does the slope mean? What does the Y-intercept mean? They love asking those questions. They also love asking questions in the calculator math section that have to do with real life word problems. So where you get a real life problem in which you have to create some sort of algebraic equation to be able to solve for a missing variable. So again, the second example I'm giving you is a grid in. We have no answer choices. You're just supposed to solve this question for X and then write in the answer that you get. Now, the last thing that I want to say about this kind of math calculator section, again, you have 55 minutes with regular time. You have 83 minutes if you get 1.5 extended time. One note, if you do get that extended time with the 83 minutes, they do cut it in half and you do get a 5-minute break in the middle. If you're taking it with regular time for 55 minutes, no break in the middle. You're going straight through for 55 minutes. Now, if you're taking the essay, after you finish the math calculator, you'll move on to the essay. If you're not taking the optional essay, then after the math calculator section, you would be done. Okay, so final takeaways for SAT math. First, non-calculator, you have 20 questions with regular time, 25 minutes, will be followed by a 5-minute break. That same 5-minute break if you get extended time and you do the non-calculator in 38 minutes. Notice that both regular time and extended time give you a 5-minute break when you finish the non-calculator section. Then you go on to the calculator section, 38 questions. Those of you with regular time will have 55 minutes. Again, if you are taking the essay, the optional essay, you will do the essay at the end after you finish the calculator math. Those of you with 1.5 extended time, instead of 55 minutes, you get 83 minutes. Notice I put the little asterisk there to make sure that you know that you do get a break in the middle if you are taking the calculator math with extended time. Notice for those of you with extended time, the non-calculator math, there's no break in the middle. You only get a break in the middle of the calculator portion of the math, not the non-calculator portion. Okay, so on behalf of Maya Learning and Winward Academy, thank you for going through this SAT math video with us. Once again, I'm Dr. Jennifer Winward with Winward Academy, and both Maya Learning and Winward Academy wish you the best of luck on your upcoming SAT, and please always feel free to connect with us for resources, insider tips, tricks, strategies, all of the above to make sure that we're helping you maximize your success and build your confidence as you're preparing for this test and for college. Thank you.